Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the MCQ question from the topic of analog Butterworth filter and Chebyshev filter. So already I posted the four videos for the first unit and one video for the basics of IIR filter, that is the infinite impulse response filter. So if you want to study means, I will give link for that videos in the description box. You can see. Or in my channel, the discrete time signal processing playlist, the videos are available in order. You can see. Okay. So now the IIR filter design, filter basics we discussed in a previous video. Now we are going to see the analog Butterworth filter design and the Chebyshev filter design questions in this video. Okay. The first question you see, the low pass Butterworth filters are also called as dash. Okay. What is this Butterworth and Chebyshev filter means? Already you know, in IIR digital filter design, there is no straight procedure in order to design the digital filter. So for the given digital specification, first we have to design the analog approximation. After that, we have to convert that analog approximation into digital filter using some techniques, bilinear transformation, impulse invariant method, and so on. Okay. So the analog approximation, there are two type of analog approximation of the filter is there. It is said to be the Butterworth. Another one is a Chebyshev. Okay, so now we are going to see that question. So the low pass Butterworth filters are also called as dash. All zero filter, all pole filter, pole zero filter, none of the above. It's a all pole filter. The low pass Butterworth filter, it is called as a all pole filters. Okay, so that means that this filter is having poles only. Okay, poles only, it doesn't have any zeros. So the roots of the denominator polynomial, we are calling it as a pole. So Butterworth filters are all pole filters. Okay, then the next one, the poles of Butterworth filter lies on the circle. The statement is true or false? True. Okay. So if you are locating the poles of Butterworth filter in a Z plane or S plane, means that all poles are located in a circular manner. It's a true. Okay. Similarly, for Chebyshev filter is also some other procedure we will see in the next question. The next one, what is the equation of the magnitude square response of low pass Butterworth filter? So magnitude square response of low pass Butterworth filter, it is given by that is 1 divided by square root of 1 plus omega divided by omega c to the power 2n. So this is the magnitude square response of the Butterworth filter. So this is the standard equation, you just remember it. Okay, so already you know this equation. In order to solve the problem, you should already know this one. So 1 divided by square root of 1 plus omega by omega c to the power 2n. It is called as the magnitude square response. Okay, so where this n, okay, this n is nothing but a order of the filter. Capital N is the order of the filter. Omega is any frequency. Omega c is a cutoff frequency. So the modulus of h of j omega is this one. Okay, then the next one, what is the transfer function of what is the transfer function of magnitude squared frequency response of normalized low pass Butterworth filter? Okay, so what is the transfer function of magnitude squared frequency response of the low pass filter? So the answer is 1 divided by 1 plus s divided by j to the power 2n. Okay, this is the magnitude squared frequency response of the Butterworth filter. Then the next one, which of the following is the band edge value of h of j omega the whole squared? Okay, so which one is the band edge value of modulus of h of j omega the whole squared? It is 1 divided by 1 plus epsilon squared. It is the band edge value of the magnitude square value, 1 by 1 plus epsilon squared. Okay, then the next thing, the magnitude square response shown below is for which of the following given filter? So in here the diagram is given. This is the frequency response, h of omega the whole squared versus frequency for various orders, n equal to 1, n equal to 4, n equal to 10. So this magnitude response is belong to which filter? Butterworth filter, Chebyshev filter, elliptical filter, or none of the mentioned? It is the Butterworth filter. Okay, this response is called as the Butterworth filter. Then the next one, the magnitude response of Butterworth filter has flat stop band, flat pass band, tapering pass band, tapering stop band. So which one is correct? The magnitude response. So already you see, this is the magnitude response of the Butterworth filter. So you see, you take any one thing, this green color for n equal to 10, you just take. So it is having, this is called as pass band. Okay, so what is mean by pass band? The range of frequency the filter will allow. This is called as a pass band. Okay. And the range of frequency, the filter, it will block. It is said to be the stop band. So this range, it is called as a stop band. So here you see this Butterworth filter is having flat pass band as well as the flat stop band. Okay. But in Chebyshev, so we will see in the next question. So the magnitude response of Butterworth filter has a flat stop band and flat pass band. So 1 and 2 is the correct answer. Okay. Then the next question. The magnitude response of the following filter decreases monotonically as the frequency increases. Okay, the magnitude response of the filter decreases monotonically as the frequency increases. Which one? Butterworth, Chebyshev type 1, type 2, FIR, Butterworth filter. So in a Butterworth filter, if you are increasing the frequency, so you see, if we are increasing the frequency, the magnitude response, it will decrease monotonically. Okay. That is the Butterworth filter. Then the next one, the transition band is more in dash. Okay, so what is mean by transition band means the range of frequency between the range of frequency occurred between the transition occurred from pass band to stop band. So here you see, this is called as a pass band, this is stop band. So here the pass band to stop band. Okay, so this is the entire, the stop band means the gain, it reaches the zero value, it is called as the stop band. Pass band means the gain of the filter is maximum, it is called as a pass band. Okay, so in between this pass band and stop band, there is this band, it is called as a transition band. Okay, so here the transition will occur, that is the magnitude response, it decreases monotonically. Okay, this is called as a transition band. So the transition band is more in which filter means Butterworth filter. So in Chebyshev and Chebyshev filter, the transition band is somewhat less, but in this Butterworth filter, the transition band is more. Okay, that is one of the characteristics of Butterworth filter. Then the poles of Butterworth filter lies on sphere, circle, ellipse, parabola. So already we discussed this question in circle. So all poles of the Butterworth filter, it locates, it lies on the circular manner. Okay, this is the important question. Then the next one, out of the given IAR filter, the following filter is the efficient one. Okay, so there are different types of design technique, that is IAR filter is the circular filter, elliptical filter, rectangular filter, Chebyshev filter. So which one is efficient one means the elliptical filter. The elliptical filter, it provides the very efficient thing. Okay. The next question, Chebyshev filter. Okay. So the above questions are discussed from the Butterworth filter. So now the Chebyshev filter. The Chebyshev filters have flat pass band, flat stop band, equiripple pass band, tapering stop band. The Chebyshev filter is having flat stop band, equiripple pass band. Okay, the pass band is somewhat this equiripple pass band. Okay, then the stop band is flat stop band. So these are all the characteristics of the Chebyshev. So 2 and 3 is the correct answer. Okay, then the poles of Chebyshev filter lies on ellipse. Okay, yes. Okay, the poles of Butterworth filter, it lies on a circular manner. But similarly, the poles of the Chebyshev filter, it lies on the elliptical manner. Okay, it lies on the ellipse. Then, which of the following is true about type 1 Chebyshev filter? In Chebyshev filter, there are two types there, Chebyshev filter type 1 and Chebyshev filter type 2. So which one is true in type 1 Chebyshev filter? Okay. Eek ripple behavior in pass band, monotonic characteristics in stop band, eek ripple behavior in pass band and monotonic characteristics in stop band. Okay, so this C, this type 1 Chebyshev filter, it is having eek ripple behavior in pass band. That is, in pass band, the eek ripple characteristics is there. Then in stop band, the monotonic characteristics is there. Okay, so like that, we will get the response. This is said to be the type 1. In type 2, the monotonic characteristics in pass band, eek ripple characteristics. So in the stop band, we will get the eek ripple characteristics. It is a type 2. Okay. Then the type 2 Chebyshev filter consists of only poles. Both poles and zeros, only zeros cannot be determined. Okay. The type 2 Chebyshev filters contains both poles and zeros. Okay, so you remember it. So the type 1 Chebyshev filter are all pole filter. Okay, type 1 Chebyshev filter are all pole filter. That is, all pole means only it is having the pole. But in the type 2 Chebyshev filter contains both poles and zeros. Okay, so in numerator also we will get some root. In denominator we will get some root. Okay, so the type 2 is a pole, contain both poles and zeros, but a type 1 is a all pole filter. Then which of the following is false about type 2 Chebyshev filter? Okay, which one is false? Monotonic behavior in pass band, eek ripple behavior in stop band, zero behavior, monotonic behavior in stop band. Okay, so the D is the wrong answer. So already I told you, in the type 1, you see, in type 1, eek ripple characteristics in pass band, monotonic behavior in stop band. In type 2, the monotonic behavior in pass band, eek ripple characteristics in stop band. So the first three is the correct. Monotonic behavior in stop band is a false statement. Then the next one, the zeros of type 2 class Chebyshev filter lies on dash. Okay, the zeros, the poles of Chebyshev filter lies on an ellipse. The zeros of Chebyshev filter lies on imaginary axis. Okay, in imaginary axis, the zeros are located. This is the imaginary axis. This x-axis is a real axis. This is the imaginary. So in imaginary axis, the zeros are located. The next one, which of the following defines the Chebyshev polynomial of order n, Tn of x? Okay. So the Chebyshev polynomial for order n, which one is correct? The C is the correct one. The T, the Chebyshev polynomial Tn of x equal to, so you see, the Tn of x is equal to cos of n into cos inverse x for the modulus of x is less than or equal to 1. Cos h of n cos h inverse of x for modulus of x greater than 1. Okay, so this is the Chebyshev polynomial. So here you see this C is the answer. Okay, the Tn of x is equal to cos n cos inverse x for modulus of x less than 1. Cos h of n cos h inverse x for modulus of x greater than 1. So this is the Chebyshev polynomial of order n. The next question, the frequency response shown in the figure below belongs to which of the following filter? Okay, so you see here the monotonic behavior in pass band and the eek ripple characteristics in stop band. Okay, so already you see the Butterworth filter means both flat pass band and flat stop band we will get. So this is not a Butterworth. In stop band, we will get a ripple characteristics. Okay. So in type 1 and type 2, in type 1 already know eek ripple in pass band, monotonic behavior in stop band. In type 2 only, the pass band is monotonic. The stop band, we will get the eek ripple. So type 2 Chebyshev. This is the type 2 Chebyshev filter. Then the next question, the following frequency characteristics is for which of the following filter? Type 2 Chebyshev filter, type 1 Chebyshev filter, Butterworth filter, Bessel filter. So you see, in stop band, we will get the ripple characteristics. So it is a type 2 only, type 2 Chebyshev. Then the next one, what is the pass band edge frequency of analog low pass normalized filter? Okay, normalized filter. So for normalized filter, always the pass band frequency, it's a 1 radians. Okay, 1 radians. So the pass band edge frequency of normalized filter is 1 radians per second. Then the next question, which of the following is a low pass to high pass transformation? So in order to convert in this Butterworth filter approximation, so we are designing first the normalized low pass filter. Normalized low pass filter means the low pass filter of cutoff frequency 1 radians. First we will design. Okay, after that we have to convert into low pass to low pass, or low pass to high pass, low pass to band pass, etc. Okay, so which one is the correct transformation in order to convert the low pass to high pass? Okay, so you just replace the S by omega U divided by S. Okay, where omega U is the cutoff frequency or edge frequency. So you just replace in HEA of S. HEA of S is called as the transfer function of analog filter. So in that transfer function of analog filter, you just replace the variable S by omega U by S. If we want to convert low pass to high pass, if you want to convert low pass to low pass, some cutoff frequency low pass means you just replace S by S divided by omega C. Okay, so these are all the important transformation. So already you used this in a problem, okay, Butterworth filter or design problems, we used this transformation. Then the next question, if H of S is the transfer function of analog low pass normalized filter and omega U is the desired pass band edge frequency of new low pass filter, okay, then which of the following transformation has to be performed? Okay, so just now I discussed, if we want to convert one normalized low pass filter into the particular cutoff frequency low pass filter, means we have to use the transformation S, we have to replace it by S divided by that cutoff frequency. Okay, a low pass to the desirable low pass filter. Okay, normalized low pass filter to some cutoff frequency low pass filter, you just replace the S by S divided by omega U. Okay, where omega is the pass band edge frequency or cutoff frequency. Normally we are saying this is the cutoff frequency. If we want to convert low pass to high pass, in the previous question, low pass to high pass, you just replace S by omega U by S. Okay, if we want to convert normalized low pass into our desirable cutoff frequency low pass, S is replaced by S by omega C. Okay, both are reciprocal. Then the next one, which one of the following is a low pass to band pass transformation? So if you want to convert that low pass to band pass filter transformation, means which one we have to use? Okay, so this B is the answer. So these formulas, you just remember it. Okay, so you put table and you just remember this. The S replaced by S squared plus omega U omega L divided by S into omega U minus omega L. Okay, if you are replacing the variable S by this term, we will get the low pass analog filter, it is converted into band pass filter, where omega U is the upper cutoff frequency, omega L is the lower cutoff frequency. Okay, omega S squared plus omega U omega L divided by S into the difference between the two cutoff frequency. This is the low pass to band pass. Okay, you just remember it. Then the next thing, the following frequency characteristics is for which of the following filter? So here you see, we will get the flat pass band and we will get the flat stop band. Okay, so this one is the Butterworth filter. Okay, so already you know the Butterworth filter is having flat pass band and flat stop band. Okay, this response, this is the Butterworth filter characteristics. Then the next one, which of the following is a low pass to band stop transformation? So already we discussed one question, low pass to band pass. Okay, if we want to convert low pass to band stop transformation, what is the thing we have to do means this one. Okay, so you see S is replaced by S into omega U minus omega L by S squared minus omega U omega L. Okay, so this is the formula in order to convert low pass to band stop. Okay, low pass to band pass, you see S squared plus omega U omega L by S into difference. Okay, this is S into omega U minus omega L by S squared minus omega U omega L. Then the next one, which of the following filter transformation is not possible? Okay, so which filter transformation is not possible? That is, we can convert low pass into some, that is normalized low pass filter into normalized different cutoff frequency low pass filter. Low pass to high pass, low pass to band pass, low pass to band stop, all available. But in this, which one is not applicable? You see, high pass analog filter to low pass digital filter, high pass analog filter to high pass digital filter, low pass analog filter to low pass digital filter, none of the mention. The high pass analog filter, we can't transform the high pass analog filter to high pass digital filter. Okay, so in anything, if it is a high pass, low pass or any filter, first we have to design the low pass filter, then we can convert into high pass in a digital transformation technique. So this thing is not possible. The next one, in direct form realization, realization of IAR filters, the denominator coefficients are multipliers in the feed forward path. Multipliers in the feedback path are positives of denominator coefficient. Numerator coefficients are multipliers in the feed forward path. Multipliers in the feedback path are negative of the denominator coefficient. So 3 and 4 is the correct answer. Okay, so while realizing the IR filter in direct form, so these two things is the correct one. Okay, 3 and 4 is the correct. That is, the numerator coefficients are multipliers in the feed forward path. Then multipliers in the feedback path are negative of the denominator coefficient. This is the correct one. Then the direct form 2 realization involves the realization of transfer function into two parts. Realization after fraction, product of two transfer function, addition of two transfer function. Okay, the cascade form. The direct form 2 realization, it involves the realization of a transfer function into two thing. Okay, so here it's not a direct form 2, this is the cascade form. So the cascade form realization, okay, cascade form realization involves the realization of transfer function into two parts and the product of two transfer function. So here the H1 of S, H of S, we can split as a H1 of S into H2 of S. We can realize individually and we have to connect it in cascade. Then the next question, the cascade realization of IAR system involves the transfer function broken into product of transfer function. Yes. Okay. That is, the H of S can be split as H1 into H2, or H1 of Z can be split, H of Z can be split as H1 of Z into H2 of Z. The transfer function divided into addition. No. Factoring the numerator and denominator polynomial, yes. Okay, in order to split, we have to factorize the numerator and denominator polynomial. Okay, so 1 and 3 is the correct one. Okay, 1 and 3 is the correct in a cascade form realization. Then the next one, the advantages of using cascade form realization is dash. It has same number of poles and zeros as that of individual components. The number of poles is the product of poles of individual component. Number of zeros is the product of poles. No, overall transfer function may be determined. Yes. Okay. So 1 and 4 is the correct one. The advantage of cascade form is that it has same number of poles and zeros as that of the individual component. Okay. And if you are multiplying all H1, H2, we will get the overall transfer function. Okay. So these are all the some of the questions about the analog Butterworth filter and Chebyshev filter. Okay. So while designing the IR filter, first we have to design the approximation, analog approximation of the particular IR filter, low pass IR filter. Then we have to convert into corresponding digital using some other transformation technique. Okay. So in the next video, we will see the analog to digital transformation techniques for this IR filter. Okay. So we'll see in the next video. So thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.